What once was one of the biggest clubs in Germany, fighting for high places in the league table, has now completely crumbled over the last decade. Schalke has won the highest division of Germany 7 times in their club history, 6 German Cups and the Europa League once. They are known for producing top talents through their academy, and whilst that is still somewhat the case currently, Schalke were relegated from the Bundesliga last season. And wasn't just an ordinary relegation, it was an embarrassing manner. Schalke gathered a total of 16 points in total, whilst Werder Bremen, who finished one place above, finished in almost double the amount of points with 31. Currently in the second Bundesliga, Schalke will have to bounce back strongly this season in order to get back where they belong, in the top division of Germany. Schalke was founded 117 years ago, in 1904. As I mentioned before, the club has won many trophies in their existence and was also the first German club to win a cup double in 1937. Schalke was ranked 7th in the UEFA club rankings in 2015. Looking at Schalke's last couple of seasons in the Bundesliga, you notice the downward spiral. Schalke finished 3rd in the 2013-14 season, followed by a 6th and 5th place in back-to-back seasons, which wasn't a big drama as they regularly had one good season in the decades prior, sometimes followed by an off-season. But in the 2016-17 season, Schalke finished 10th. They somehow did manage to finish 2nd in the season after, finishing above the likes of Hoffenheim, Dortmund, Leverkusen, Leipzig and even Stuttgart. Players such as Weston McKennie, Leon Goretzka, Max Meyer, Yevgen Konoplyanka, Brill Embolo, Naldo, Thilo Kerrer and top goalscorer Guido Burgstaller were just some of the standout players in the squad. But after this successful season, where Schalke also reached the semi-final of the German Cup, a couple of players were sold, such as Goretzka. The club had a tough follow-up season, finishing 14th. Not only did they have to deal with the loss of key players, but they also had more fixtures because of the Champions League. Porto finished 1st in the group, followed by Schalke in 2nd, Galatasaray in 3rd and Lokomotiv Moscow in last place. Schalke went on to play the round of 16, where they got knocked out by Manchester City. The first leg was lost 3-2, which still gave Schalke hopes of advancing, but the German club had no chance in the second leg, as Man City went on to win 7-0. The season after, Schalke finished 12th, and in the season after, 2020-21, the Koningsblauwe were relegated. Schalke had a disaster of a start to the season, becoming the 5th team to go winless in the first 14 matches. They also became the first Bundesliga team with 5 different managers in a season. They started off the season horribly already, with an 8-0 loss to Bayern Munich to open the season, before conceding another 7 goals in the next 2 matches against Werder Bremen and Leipzig. Schalke were officially relegated on the 20th of April, after a 1-0 loss to Arminia Bielefeld. Their top goalscorer was Matthew Hoppe with 6 goals, who actually helped them get their first win of the season with a hat-trick against Hoffenheim. The second win only came on the 11th of April against Augsburg, 1-0. When Schalke was officially relegated already, they did manage to win their third and last match of the season in a 4-3 win against Frankfurt. Many players joined the club in both the summer and winter transfer window, including Sead Kolasinac returning to his former club, Shokdran Mustafi and Klaas-Jan Huntelaar, who also left Ajax to return to his former club in order to try and save them from relegation. Schalke do have one of the brightest academies in the world though, producing talents that reach the top level of the footballing world or either buy players at a very low cost and turn them into solid players. Some players are Manuel Neuer from Bayern Munich, Thilo Kerrer from PSG, Julian Draxler from Paris Saint-Germain, Ivan Rakitic from Sevilla, Mesut Özil from Fenerbahce, Leon Goretzka from Bayern Munich, Weston McKennie from Juventus, Leroy Sané from Bayern Munich, Ilkay Gundogan from Manchester City and Joel Matip from Liverpool. When you take a look at a couple of records of Schalke, then the player with the most appearances is Klaus Fischer, who played 477 matches for the club. A current player that's closest to this is Ralf Veerman, who has 266 appearances for the club so far and is in 18th place in the all-time appearances list. The club top goalscorer is also Klaus Fischer with 182 goals, followed by Klaas-Jan Huntelaar with 84. The current Schalke player with the most goals is Simon Terodde, who has scored just 12 goals for the club and he is in 86th place on the all-time top goalscorers list. The youngest player to play for the club is Volker Abramczyk, who was 17 years and 95 days old. The youngest goalscorer in the club history is Julian Draxler, who scored when he was 17 years and 127 days old. The most goals in a season in all competitions is a record held by Klaas-Jan Huntelaar, who scored 48 goals in the 2011-12 season. The player with the most league goals in a season is Klaus Fischer and Huntelaar, both with 29 goals. These are definitely records that you can break in FIFA 22 career mode, and I would highly recommend to keep track of these to make the save a bit more enjoyable. So if you want to do a Schalke career mode in FIFA 22, then your first goal will be to bring the club back to the Bundesliga. Eventually you will have to win the Bundesliga again with Schalke, also winning the German Cup at least once. Something that Schalke have never won in their history is the Champions League, so win that as well throughout this journey. Obviously, you will have to make good use of the youth academy as well to try and bring more amazing players into the world of football through Schalke's academy. I would recommend to mainly scout in Germany, the Netherlands, Brazil and Austria. You can't recall the loan out players in the first season, as that would make it too easy to get out of the second division. Standout players who are loaned out are Ozan Kabak, Amin Harit, Gabi Matondo and Hamza Mandil. You can use them again when you manage to get promoted to the Bundesliga in the first season, so these players will only return to the club when they are in the Bundesliga. If you didn't manage to get promoted in the first season, then you will have to sell these players to other clubs and you are not able to spend that money on players, at least not when you are in the second division. Also try to break the records I mentioned before, so you will need a player that plays more than 477 matches for the club in a career mode and a player who breaks the club top goalscorer record of 182 goals. Try to also score more than 48 goals in a season with one player and to score more than 29 goals in a Bundesliga season. Some players I would recommend to buy for Schalke in the first season of the career mode are Finn Becker from St. Pauli, who is a 21-year-old centre mid with a 69 rating and 80 potential, Sarpreet Singh from Regensburg, who is a 22-year-old attacking midfielder with a 68 rating and 77 potential, Johan Gomez from Zwickau, who is a 64 rated centre forward with 79 potential at 19 years of age, Bartosz Bielek from Wolfsburg, who is a 19-year-old striker with a 68 rating and 81 potential, Miguel Kisans from Bayern Munich, who isn't getting any playing time currently but is still 73 rated with an 80 potential and he is still just 21 years of age, Tommy Santiago from Utrecht, who is a 21-year-old centre-back with a 70 rating and 80 potential, Jaden Oosterwolde from FC Twente, who is a 20-year-old left-back that can also play as a centre-back, he is 66 rated and has 79 potential. All in all, Schalke is a fantastic choice for a career mode in FIFA 22. It's definitely a fallen giant that you will have to get back to the top of football. Besides the stadium being in the game and having some nice kits, Schalke has a great history which helps to get a bit more immersed into the career mode. Their current squad is quite challenging to deal with, as many talents have been sold or loaned out due to their relegation last season. They still have Malek Diaw, Ko Itakura, Rodrigo Salazar, Mehmet Aydin and Kerem Çalhanoğlu as some of their biggest talents. Besides that, they still have veterans like Simon Terodde, Ralf Veerman and Salif Sané. Unfortunately, only a couple of players have a scanned game face, which is disappointing. If I have to rate them, I would give Schalke an 8.5 out of 10 as a rating, as they have a great history, some good storylines to use in career mode, and they also have some fine kits and their stadium in the game. Which team should I highlight in the next episode? Let me know in the comments below. If you enjoyed this video, then be sure to give it a like and subscribe to my channel to not miss another episode, and I will see you at the next video.